What is up, guys? Welcome to Garage 23. And this is our 1998 Nissan Skyline. And in a previous episode, we installed a max speeding rods factory replacement turbo. And in this episode, we're gonna do a comparison between that and the stock turbo, as well as do a short-term review on how this turbo has been performing so far. So let's check it out. All right, welcome class. This is Professor Red, and this is stuff they should have taught you in school, Turbo Geometry 101.
This year is gonna be totally awesome!
So before we start talking about turbo, we need to go over the terms and stuff that describe the turbo and its size. So basically all turbos can be divided straight down the middle, and you have your cold side and your hot side. The hot side consists of your turbine and turbine housing. The cold side consists of your compressor and compressor housing. The middle is the CHRA, and this is the part that flows your coolant and oil and has your bearings in it. And both of these turbos cases, they're both oil journal bearing turbos, so not ball bearing. The terms that describe the size of the turbos is gonna be your trim, your AR, and your compressor wheel. And that one's the simplest, so we'll start with that one. A lot of the times, a lot of race classes are actually dictated by this dimension alone. So a lot of times you'll hear, oh, he's running a 76 mil turbo, or he's running like a 90 mil turbo or something like that. That's pertaining to the diameter of the inducer of the compressor. So if you look at the compressor wheel, this is the part that you see out the front of the turbo. So the fancy cool part that spins, that's the compressor inducer.
The compressor inducer, hi.
And this size is what you hear referring to the turbo size in general. That's the easiest one. This is a 52.7 mil turbo, and the stock one was a 48.6 mil turbo. So just on that dimension, we have a 4.1 millimeter increase. The next term is gonna be AR, and I've been calling this aspect ratio for all the way up until like a week ago. It is not aspect ratio, it's actually area over radius. And you'll ask, well, what area and what radius? That's also kind of complicated because it's not something you can really measure easily. So you can find the AR for the compressor housing and the turbine housing, but this term is usually used to refer to the turbine housing. And so if you take your little turbine housing, you got your four bolt flange, and then you have your little snaily bits. Then you have your wheel in here. So the area I thought was the area of the flange here, which should be great because that's super easy to measure, just here to here, here to here. But it's not there. It's actually the area of the section of the turbine housing that lines up with the center of the turbine itself. So from here straight up, this is going to be your area. And then the radius is the center of that area versus the center line of the turbine itself. So that's your radius, and then that's your area. So you divide that by that, and then that'll give you this kind of number, a 0.63 or 0.43, 1.16, 1.5, something like that. And basically what this number is telling you is the flow capacity of the turbine housing. So the bigger the number, the more volume of air that it can flow. The smaller the number, the less volume it can flow. And so you can use any kind of turbo on your engine, right? You could put a 0.43 housing on your engine, or you could put a 1.5 housing on your engine. That's just gonna dictate how long it takes you to hit boost and how big of a restriction you're gonna have in the power band. So say you put a 0.43 housing on your engine, and say that's an LS1. LS1's got 5.7 liters of displacement. That's gonna max out that housing super quick. You're gonna hit boost at like 1500 RPM. It's gonna be great. And then it turns into a restriction immediately after, and you can't have a very good top end. So that's where you'd want a large AR housing, like a 1.5 or something like that, because you have all that volume of air that needs to move through the turbo efficiently. And so you'd put a 1.6 or something AR housing, and that'll be better for your big V8. Whereas if you had like a 1.8 liter Honda, you'd want to stick to something closer to like a 0.43, 0.63 maybe even. Now we're talking about RB engines, so 0.63 is about where you want to be for a stock street car. And I've seen anywhere from 0.63 to 0.83 on street cars. Obviously you can keep going from there. There's big 1,000 horsepower RBs with, you know, 1.2 rear housing, something like that. And that just depends how much power you're making and where you want the power band to be. On a big drag car, obviously you want a lot of flow on the top end, so you want a big AR rear housing. This is a street car though, so we have a 0.63. And the stock one also was right about there, 0.64 for the stock rear housing. That's on the R34 though. The R33 and 32 have a 0.5 rear housing. So that'd be a good upgrade. If you had a 32 or 33, you could upgrade to a 34 turbo and you have a little bit better top end. So the next term that is listed on Max Speeding Rod's website and a lot of other turbo manufacturers is the trim. The trim is a ratio between the small diameter and the large diameter of the turbine or compressor wheels. And so you get this number by taking the, I want to say inducer, but on the turbine, this is the exducer and this is the inducer. But if you do the math that way, I can't get it to work out. So I think it's just the small diameter versus the big diameter. So you take the small one, square it, and then divide it by the large diameter and square that. And then you times it by 100 and that gives you the trim. And you round up to the nearest, you know, decimal, and that gives you this number. The trim, every article I found regarding the trim for compressor and turbine wheels was like, it basically tells you the general amount of flow capacity that that particular wheel has. But then most articles went out to say that with current like materials and designs, like the material density and like design characteristics of each specific wheel have a greater effect on the capacity than this number does. So it's not like a good indication of overall performance. On that note, I don't know how important this number actually is. It seems like it's not very important at all, but I don't know. If you guys know more about this than I do, feel free to chime in the comments. But that's gonna be the basic specs regarding turbos. So any questions so far?
Sir, what kind of training is this?
No? Okay. So with regards to comparing the stock turbo and the Max Speeding Rod's turbo, on the start with the compressor, we have a 48.6 mil compressor on the stock turbo and a 52.7 millimeter inducer on the Max Speeding Rod's turbo. That's an increase of 4.1 millimeters. And on the exducer, the stock one was 66.5 versus the MXR turbo at 76 millimeters. That's the biggest increase here at 9.5 millimeters of increase. And then on the turbine, the stock one was 43 on the exducer. The MXR one is 47.9, an increase of 4.9 millimeters. And then on the inducer on the turbine, 57 millimeters versus 64.4 on the Max Speeding Rod's turbo, an increase of 7.4. So obviously you can see the Max Speeding Rod's turbo is substantially bigger, and yet it manages to fit in the stock location and the stock dimensions of the manifolds and everything like that. They also rate this to up to 500 horsepower. And just judging by the increase in volume, I mean, I think it should be able to get close to that. I don't know about 500 exactly, but should definitely be in the 400s. Cause I mean, even the stock turbo with these specs, most of them hit around the mid 300s. So I don't think this one should have any trouble at least getting in the 400s. 500s though, I think is a bit of a steep claim, but I do want to test that, but probably not at the moment. And we'll go over that next in our short-term review of our experience so far with the turbo. So obviously one of the main differences is the materials here, because the stock turbo, the compressor is made up of nylon and the turbine is made of ceramic. So plastic and Play-Doh basically. And the MXR turbo is cast aluminum on the compressor and some sort of metal alloy on the turbine. And that's substantially more reliable than the stock one. So that's the biggest benefit here, and that's the main reason that I've told you guys, like in the last video, this along with the price at $95, this should just be scheduled maintenance when you get your car off the boat, like just on that reliability factor. But it has to be said, along with that, it kind of causes other issues. So being that it's so much bigger, we saw an increase in a little bit of an increase in lag. So like say on low boost, on the stock turbo, we were hitting peak boost, which low in our case was about 10 PSI on the stock turbo. We were hitting peak boost at around 3,500 RPM. Whereas with the Max Speeding Rod's turbo on low boost, we were hitting that at about 4,300 RPM. And now on high boost, that's the main issue with the OEM turbo. You don't really have a high boost option. This thing tops out at 14 PSI, and that's your limit. You want to stay under 14. If you want to set it to 14 exactly, that's still a bit of a risk, but I would say stay under 14. It was hitting that at like under 4,000 RPM, so like 30, I want to say like 38-ish. The max speeding rods turbo is hitting max boost on high PSI. We have that set to 15, and it's hitting max boost at about 4,500 RPM. So that's an increase of about 1,000 RPM. That's obviously a big increase in lag, or it's not a huge increase, but it's an increase. And that's just due to the volume of air that we're moving. And with that, it kind of cancels out, because on the stock turbo, you'd have to run more boost for the same amount of power because it's moving less air. Whereas on the max speeding rods turbo, you don't have to run as much boost because you're already moving more air. So the same boost rating for between both of these turbos isn't the same. Like, it's not the same amount of power or the same amount of air. That's one of the negatives on this one, because when we try to run high boost, that's a lot bigger volume of air that we're trying to move, and the car's just not set up for that. And we're seeing that in the form of like weird surging under throttle and like a couple of backfire incidents, which I'm not super sure about, but like this is just due to the fact that we're not set up to dump as much fuel as this turbo needs. So that's going to necessitate us upgrade, you know, the fuel pump, the injectors, and inevitably the engine management. So that's going to be later on down the line. But what we can do is we can still run low boost, which is still, I want to say the low boost on this turbo is better than what the high boost was on this one, which it only ran high boost for like 2 days and blew up. This also, what I want to add to that is that's only because we have a Series 1 R34. So this is a 98 car, and that's a Series 1. I can't really verify this, so if you guys have a newer R34, or at least the turbo, if you guys can verify this, the Series 2 and 3 R34s didn't have ceramic wheels. And I've heard the Series 2 still had a nylon wheel, but it had a steel turbine. And the Series 3 R34 had aluminum compressor and steel turbine wheels. That would explain why our S14 didn't blow up at 15 PSI, but obviously we don't have that car anymore, so I can't verify that. But if you guys have any one of those turbos, feel free to chime in the comments. I will say the low boost setting on the max speeding rods turbo now is fantastic. That's peak performance for this car right now, and we're loving it. Like I said, I still recommend this turbo highly, just if you still have the stock turbo, just based on the reliability and the value. The value being the biggest thing, because for $95, the confidence in knowing the turbo's not gonna blow up and leave you on the side of the road or something, that's worth it in my book. So that's gonna be it for this episode, and class dismissed. No homework for this weekend, but remember, always do your best.